The hero's journey is a framework that we use in our inner and outer ecology programs. This framework is adapted from the idea of the hero in the book Hero with a Thousand Faces by Joseph Campbell. The basic premise of this intervention is that every person is a hero unto himself or herself. For those who want to move away from the mainstream and go on a path less traveled, the hero's journey provides an amazing framework that is at once exciting and settling. It is exciting to give one's struggles a new meaning as part of being on a heroic path, and settling because the negative meanings that might have been given to one's victimhood, struggles, anger, or helplessness are dissolved. These feelings that sometimes rein in our exuberance for the journey can be made wholesome and dignified. Also, unlike Campbell's much-hyped individual hero, the eco-hero is someone who values community. We offer here a conversation between a wise woman and a young man. This conversation gives a glimpse of the hero's journey and how the path of adventure unfolds.
Hey, you there! Are you a hero?
Who? Me? A hero? I'm just an ordinary person.
So you mean to say that a hero is not an ordinary person?
No. He is an ordinary person, but he does things that are extraordinary.
Extraordinary? Such as?
Such as, he has concerns about what happens in his context, and he takes it upon himself to change the situation that are not working well. He gets restless and takes action.
What I hear you say is that a hero tunes in with the environment and receives the call to adventure.
Yeah. That's what I wanted to say.
So does he set out on his journey immediately?
He wants to, but he has so many doubts and questions. And also the world around him says that you've gone crazy. Why don't you focus on your own career path or do the done things? There are others to take care of the world, so on and so forth.
Yes, dear, the hero's path is such. The hero needs to engage with questions and doubts, anchor in his convictions, and cross the threshold. He also needs to fight with the father.
Fight with the father?
Fight with the father metaphorically means the rigid system, the authority, the unquestioned norms that push you to a narrow path and does not allow you an adventurous journey that your heart may want to take.
Wow, you say it so poetically.
So what happens next?
What next? That's what makes him a hero. That he listens to his own voice and ventures out to change the world.
Does he get any help in his journey?
Yeah, he does get help, you know. He meets random people who give him information. And in addition to that, he equips himself with reading and research.
So if the hero is so well informed, does he quickly achieve his target?
Not so soon, ma'am. He too goes through ups and downs. Doubts and questions come back to him. At times, he feels like giving up and going back to the done things.
Yeah. So he goes into the belly of the whale.
You're using very nice terms. I don't fully understand them, and yet they're making sense. What do you mean by the belly of the whale?
Some things are left to be experienced, but I can surely try and explain. The belly of the whale is a dark period that a hero has to encounter in order to go forth. This is the time when he has to delve deep within and find answers and the courage to continue on his path.
Okay, that means he gets some clarity and goes on a smooth journey?
Not so soon, young man. Every hero has to go through the road of trials.
Where he encounters difficulties and challenges? Yeah, that's the difference I was talking about. An ordinary person may not want to take such risks.
Yes, but what seems so difficult when you do it alone becomes more possible when others join in your journey.
But who would join?
Well, when you're aligned to your intent and stay strong in your conviction, the hero almost invariably meets co-travelers who will join him. Faith is the word.
I guess you're right. But for that, hero needs to accept that he does not have the power to do everything, you know, and allow himself to seek from others.
What else does he need to do?
What else? I guess he also needs to access all that exists in him, like his tough side as well as gentle side, taskiness and creativity, to stay focused on his path and be light.
Absolutely right. The hero is not only bold, courageous and adventurous. A hero also needs to be a strategist. Take people along. Be sensitive to the context. Be gracious, accepting, etc., etc. And in our world of wise men and women, we call it the integration of masculine and feminine. It is there within us. We just need to be conscious of it.
So, when a person has all of this, he can take any challenge in his stride, isn't it?
Well, true at one level. Yet at the same time, he needs to believe that all of this resides within him and he can draw from this immense source anytime he needs. Then it becomes an eternal source of power. And every time he takes the journey of adventure, this resource gets kindled and enhanced.
Yes, absolutely. I agree.
So, is a hero only a man?
In films, they mostly show like that. But in reality, a hero can be a man or a woman. I think my mother is a hero.
Yes, you're right, my dear. Though we use the masculine term hero, it implies to both women and men. Now tell me, are you a hero?